Today we're going to create high contrast portrait similar to dragon effect by adding highly detailed eyes and skin using the free Snapseed app. Here I have opened the image in Snapseed. First, opening Tune Image menu. We'll decrease the highlights to get as many details from the brighter parts of the face. Also increasing shadows to recover details mainly from the eyes here. Now using black and white filter to convert to black and white. We'll check if changing color options will give a good head start here. But we'll settle with neutral option. Next, opening curves. We'll crush the blacks further here. Darkening the overall image further with another curves effect. Here we need to recover details back on the eyes and the teeth. So going back to the masking screen on the curves filters and removing the effect to get brightness back here on the teeth and the eyes. We're gonna enhance these in the later steps. To do that, opening brush tool for some dodge and burning to enhance the eyes. With brush value set at -5 for burning, brushing on the darker parts here to further darken them. On the brighter part of the iris to make it more shiny. Brushing carefully on these rough edges around the eyes for more enhancement. We'll do similar dodge and burn on the teeth. Next, using curves, we'll fix the contrast by adding some more whites. Applying it in the masking screen on eyes and the teeth. Here's the difference now. Now, going to tonal contrast filter. We'll increase the value on the medium tones only so that the contrast is increased only on the mid tones, which pops the portrait more. Adding one more tonal contrast effect. Using curves, I'm gonna make curve like this to make the image dark grayish. Going to masking screen, we'll apply the effect with a bit less transparency on the surroundings. more dodge and burning with the brush tool now. Brushing on parts of the face to enhance features on some areas. Zooming in and taking time to fine-tune the bright and dark parts here. Also enhancing the turban. Going back for some masking work. On top of this, applying some vignetting with the vintage filter. Some masking work to make it a bit more interesting. I'm gonna also make it more grainy with the grainy film filter. Removing the style strength completely, not want to add any color here. Adding a lot of grain here for some rough look. Tuning overall contrast. We'll be moving to Lightroom app now to make some final tunings, as Lightroom gives more control with whites and blacks. Here in light menu, tuning whites to make it not too overexposed. Also blacks. Tuning the curves. Also adding sharpness selectively using masking slider in detail menu. Adding sharpness. The final result here. Hope you found these tips useful, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.